Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through digital data to analog signal, guys. Guys, the next two topics are not so clear because I didn't understand it so properly, guys. So I have just written the steps, what are the different types of approaches in which we will be doing it, okay? So first, let us go through digital data to analog signal conversion. So when data, okay, when a data from one computer is sent to another via some analog carrier or analog cable, so it is first converted into analog signal, right? Yes, that's true. So digital data is indirectly converted into analog signal. So analog signals, how many ways can we represent analog signals, guys? With respect to amplitude, with respect to frequency, and with respect to phase. So with respect to them, how we will be representing? So that is what this conversion is. Amplitude, shifting, keying. So it is nothing but when a binary data represents digital 1, so the amplitude is high. So here it is representing 1, so the amplitude is high. So when the binary data representing is 0, the amplitude is constant, that is 0. So in this way, we will be representing in amplitude shifting key. Fine. Similarly, frequency shifting key. I hope everyone knows that when amplitude is high, the frequency will be really, really high, so that in a short area only, there could be many number of cycles, right? So that is the reason why here for 0 on frequency F1, we will be having high frequency. Fine. So similarly, for another frequency F2, if it is low, we will be having only few cycles. Fine. So this is nothing but with respect to frequency. So with respect to phase, so basically if it is at 1 and if it is at 0, if it is at 1 and it is staying at 1, it could be constant. But if it is from 1, it changes to 0, means it's a phase change, right? Like 90 degrees or 180 degrees, however you represent it. Fine. So that is what this phase shifting is, guys. So when a new binary symbol encounters, the phase will change, guys. So basically, if it is 1, it is in this way. If it is 0, it should not go up, it should come from down. Okay, if it is 1, it will continue up. If it is 1, it continues up. If it is 0, it will be coming down. So I hope everyone got a clear idea on this. Guys, this is just the introduction, guys. If possible, just go through some problems if they are available. So I hope everyone is now clear with it. So in the next tutorial, we will be going through analog data to analog signal. Thank you. Thanks for watching.